All are doing fine. So in this video we are going to discuss about mailbox. So what is mailbox? Mailbox is mainly used to exchange information, right? As you would have got to known from the name mail and box. So it is basically used to send the information from one process to another process. So basically there are types of mailbox. So one type is a generic type and one is a parameterized type. So there are type that is generic type and parameterized. So in case of a generic type, what is happening? Generic type can accept any type of data. Any type of data is accepted. But in case, but if you want that only certain type of data only need to be sent, or only certain specific type of the data only you need to process. So in that case, you can go for a parameterized type that is only for specific data. Okay, and there is also a concept which is a bounded and unbounded. So in case of a bounded, what is happening? The size of the mailbox is limited. And in case of unbounded, the size is unlimited, that you can send any amount of data. So let's go and implement one example where we will implement two process and we will send the data from one process to another process. So we will directly do this process handling in, or we will implement the process in module only. So module TV. So in this, what we will do, we will declare one mailbox first. So how to declare mailbox is, you have to write mailbox, then you have to write the, this keyword is a mailbox itself, the name itself mailbox, and you have to give the name. Suppose let's say VLSI chaps. Okay, this is our name of the mailbox, and let's assign memory to it. Okay, and let's declare one process. This is the process initial begin end. We will declare two process, initial begin. So these two processes are happening in initial begin. So in one process we will declare one data type. So let's take data type as always bit 3 down to 0A. So for this is our data type. And what we will do, we'll randomize the data that we need to send. So let's, or we will, for example, we will give 10. So we are sending information 10. So how to send the data is, write the name of the mailbox dot put. So here to send the data we have put method to send data and get method to receive data. Okay, so this is information we have. So input you have to write the variable name. So let's display also. Let's display that data sent is percent D and A. Okay, so here also, now here we will receive the data, that is 3 down to 0 A, and to receive the data mailbox name VLSHF dot get, and we'll write A and we will display what data we are getting. So we'll write here data received is percent D, and here like this, and we'll go end module. Okay, so let's run this. So select the tool here from here, that is a Synopsys VCS. So if you see that we are sending the data which is 10 and we are receiving the data which is 10. So this is how the mailbox work. So let's send some good amount, or like more amount of data. So for sending that, let's randomize it first. Let's write A is equal to dollar random, and we will write here one for loop. I is equal to 0, I less than 10, I plus plus. So we have to write in this and begin end. Okay, so 10 times we are randomizing the data and we are sending it. So here also we have to receive the data in that fashion only, right? So we will use for each begin and end. So let's run this. Not for each, you can, okay, forever begin and end. So if you see here, the data which we are sending first is 4. We are receiving first is 4, then the data we are sending is 1. So this is data send is 1. So the data send is 9, 3, 13, 13, 5, 2, 1. So here also 3, 3, 9, 5, 3, 3. So this is how the mailbox is used. So this is how we implemented two process. We developed a two process and we are sending the data. For sending the data, use put method. For receiving the data, use get method. So this is a basic use case of mailbox. So this is a generic mailbox which can send any type of the data. So I will make a separate video for parameterized mailbox also, and we will declare one test bench, or we will develop one test bench in which we will see how we can make use of mailbox. So today for now I will stop. So please do like, share and subscribe to our channel, and also press the bell icon so that you will receive a notification whenever we upload a video. And do join our Telegram channel, which is VLSI Chaps. So see you soon, guys.